The focus of today's war strategy will be the highest court that matters, and the scripture will be Psalms 94, verses 20 through 23. And it says, "Shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by a law? They gather themselves together against the soul of the righteous, and condemn the innocent blood. But the Lord is my defense, and my God is the rock of my refuge. And he shall bring upon them their own iniquity, and shall cut them off in their own wickedness. Yea, the Lord our God shall cut them off." The strategy: a nation that create laws which violates the law of God breaks fellowship with the Lord. The Lord shall remove his blessing from that country. That country will be guilty of treason against the Lord and shall be punished in the courts of high heaven. When a nation creates laws of sin as a national standard, it gives the wicked the legal authority to persecute unjustly the righteous, which are now considered lawbreakers. The system now works against the people of God with no advocate in the land to plead their case. The innocent is found guilty in the courts of the wicked. The Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord, is our advocate, our defense, our strong tower. Today is the day to put away the wicked laws of man and bind the eternal law of God in our hearts. Though the courts of this wicked world will seek to persecute the righteous and innocent, the highest court of heaven shall give the final rule, the final verdict concerning the saints. To the wicked nation that frames mischief by a law, it will be by these same laws that they shall be condemned and destroyed forever. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much for being our mighty advocate in these end times. For Lord, we know that the enemy has been working on a plan to destroy the saints, to see that your name, Father, is disgrace, and that an abomination is made of it throughout the ends of the earth. And so we see the abominations and the sins and the idolatries which surround us, O God. And many of your saints, Father, are growing weary of seeing all the evil that is prevalent in the world today and all the mockery against your name. And so we seek of a better home, Father, a better country, a country far better and far greater than what we are in today, Father. But we continue to wait patiently, Father, wait in our weariness, not give up, to not give in and not conform, Father, to the wickedness of this world. And so we pray, oh God, that you will continue to sustain us. We pray that you will continue to give us the energy to press on for another minute, one more minute, and one more minute afterwards, as long as it takes, Father, until our deliverance come. For Father, we know that in your word, you says that shall you have fellowship with a nation, Father, which pretty much makes mischief, which creates laws, Father, to cover up their sins. And it says that you shall not. And this is something that we must take to heart, that in your word, Father, we know that your word is true and is inerrant and you do not lie. But if a nation begins to create laws that violates your law and begins to cover up the mischief of their ways by trying to legalize these things into practices, O God, you said that you will not have fellowship with this nation. And if you don't have fellowship with them, then that means you are not allies with that nation anymore. And if you are not allies with that nation anymore, Father, then that nation has become your enemy. And you have nothing to do with that nation. And so, Father, we must really consider the state of the world today as to how many laws has been put in place, Father, that has violated your kingdom law, your principle, which guarantees liberty and life and freedom for all your people, O God. For all those, Father, who seek to do better, who seeks to see that righteousness and judgment is seen throughout the land, and that your name continues to be uplifted and glorified, Father, and that your Ten Commandments continue to keep us on the straight and narrow, so this way we may be the people who love you with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love our neighbors as ourselves. But Father, we see that the enemy has done a great work upon the minds of the people of this generation, and that much lawlessness abounds, O God. And so as every law is legalized, Father, which goes against your commandment, is another law that the wicked can use to persecute the saints. And so we see this happening in an even greater measure all around us, O God. And so, Father, you're giving us the early start, the early warning, Father. You're allowing us to see with the eyes of a watchman down the road to see what is coming. And that for every law that is enacted, which is against your law, Father, is another law that gives the legal grounds for the wicked to persecute the saints. And we thank you so much, Father, for not leaving us without help. For in your word, Father, you said that you are our defense. You are our fortress. You are our strong tower. You are our refuge. You are our solid rock. And so, Father, it is only you, Father, that we will have as our advocate. You that we have as our defense, our warrior king, Father, our defender, our bodyguard in these time to come. So we pray, Father, that we will begin to start casting away the things that binds us up, Father, that keeps us from binding your word into our hearts, O God, with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. We pray, Father, that you begin to bind up the works of the evil man, O God, bind up the works of the strong man and cast them to the abyss in Jesus' name. We pray, Father, that you begin to start putting a holy hedge of protection round about the minds and the hearts of your people, for we're going to need every bit of prayer, Father, every ounce of your grace that we can get to endure what is to come because of the great shaking and the great testing that shall be upon your people, O God. And so we thank you so much, Father, that you let us know that even though that the enemy will come in as a flood, that you shall be a standard in our lives against the wicked, Father, and that we shall be a beacon of light reflecting your glory, O God, to let it be known that your word stands forever and is never changing, O God. It is unchanging. And so, Father, we thank you so much, O Lord, that you says that even so, that even if the laws of wickedness begins to be prevalent upon a land which gives legal grounds, Father, by the sight of the wicked to persecute the saints, he says that it shall not be so, Father, because you shall be our defense in the highest courts of heaven, and to see that our cases are heard, and at every case, Father, is we are found innocent. And then also you said that the very laws that the wicked has enacted will be the very laws that shall condemn and destroy those who brought into being, O God. And so we thank you so much for the courage and the strength that you've given us to stand. And we pray that you begin to anoint the eyes and the ears of the people so they may understand the time that we are living in, O God. For many places are seeing your judgment falling already in different measures, and some places have not, but yet if they open their eyes in the spiritual realm and see round about them, oh God, they will see the hour that we are living in, the time that we're living in, that we must be ready, that we must prepare ourselves for action and for warfare, oh God, for spiritual warfare, because the time of going into our prayer closets, oh God, is upon us, oh Lord, and it's time for us to go and be the spiritual prayer warriors that we are called to be armored up, and to go and to speak your words into existence and begin to demolish all the plans of the enemy, to bring down the strongholds of the enemy this day. Lord, we thank you so much for hearing our prayer, and thank you so much for being our mighty warrior king and advocate. Prepare us, O God. Give us boldness, O God. May you continue to strengthen us, O Lord, in thy holy presence, O Lord. And may you give us the sufficient grace that we will need to accomplish all the assignments that you have planned for us. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you. And we thank you so much, Father, for continuing to keep us, Father, in all things. May you continue to keep us, Father, in your company, O Lord. And may we not allow anyone to steal our crown. O God, help us to stand firm. Help us to be bold in accordance with Joshua chapter 1 verse 9. O God, where you tell us to be strong and of a good courage. Do not fear. Do not be afraid. That you will be with us, Father, wherever we go, as long as we keep your commandments, O God. And this is what's going to be the biggest test. The biggest test, Father, that we're going to face is to keep your commandments. For when we keep your commandments, then we are found innocent in the courts of heaven because of your blood, which makes us innocent, O God, because we're walking in the innocence, O Lord, of our hearts before you, O Lord, that has been washed in your blood, O Lord. And so we pray that we will not lose sight, because the moment that we decide to retaliate in wickedness, O God, because of the wickedness that surrounds us, then we become in violation of thy eternal laws, Father, in the courts of heaven. And so therefore, there will be a consequence for it, O Lord. But to stay in your will, to stay in your word, and to stay in your law, Father, that you have ordained for us to follow, O God, to keep your commandments in our hearts, soul, mind, and strength, O Lord. And we pray that we will continue to go forth, Father, and be a shining beacon in a place filled with darkness and the lost. And may many people come to salvation in this upcoming harvest season. We love you, Lord, and it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I blew breath in you before, and I can do it again. I am God, and I give you a second wind.
A person. son of faith. I know God will do just what he said. But being honest with myself, sometimes I struggle with myself. Where did the time go? Is it slipping away? As relevant now as it was back when I blew breath in you before, and I will do it again. I am God, and I give you a second wind.
Hey, yeah.
I give you a second wind.